Kashadu. Hopping from branch to branch with delightful songs and pretty, pretty feathers, who doesn't appreciate the beauty of birds? However, lurking amongst them are some sickos that should be doing time in battery farm cages. Not much bigger than your common thrush, the great grey shrike, with his cheery mating calls, looks like a harmless little fella. He loves to invite other songbirds to dinner by mimicking their calls. But little do his dinner guests realize that they're about to have their heads bashed in by the shrike's hooked beak, which has evolved specifically to smash open skulls and tear through flesh. If there's too much for the shrike to devour in one sitting, he's not a greedy little bird. He'll find a sharp spike, such as a thorny tree or a barbed wire fence, and impale his victim for later. The rotting carcass also doubles as a trophy fence around the perimeter of his territory to ward off his adversaries and impress the hens. Don't judge him too harshly. Save some of that disdain for other members of the depraved flock. Even Jonathan Livingston Seagull has a dark side, and we're not talking about taking a sneaky shit on tourists or stealing chips. While Greenpeace is busy harassing whalers, the kelp gull likes nothing better than to swoop down and tear large pieces of flesh from the backs of giant whales. However, these avian atrocities are nothing compared to Thailand's indigenous serial soul thieves, the Shadu. Tourists arriving at Thailand's temples are routinely bothered by plagues of street hawkers selling Buddhist charms and tacky souvenirs. Usually, sat off to one side, you'll notice a couple of wizened old ladies sat cross-legged with one hand raised in the default begging position, while the other hand tends to tiny chirping birds in cramped cages.
Oh, that's dead cruel, that is. Look at them birds over there. There's no room for them to move in them dirty cages. Hello, you. Free bird now. Good luck for you now. 10 baht. You, madam.
The husband grabs the elderly tourist by the arm.
Come on, love, walk away. It's a con. They train them to fly back in cages like racing pigeons. Oh, that's bloody awful, that is.
Yes, lady, it is, but not for the reasons you're thinking. Those overexcited little birds are the Shadu, also referred to as shadow suckers. They are the lesser-known black sheep of the Trochilidae clan, better known as the hummingbird family. Hovering in midair, most hummingbirds have wing flapping rates of about 50 to 200 times per second. This allows them to fly at speeds exceeding 34 miles per hour. This is a snail's pace compared to the Shadu. They flap their wings so fast that the hum isn't audible to the human ear. Their speeds can't be measured because they can't be seen as they shift into stealth mode to mask their physical form. Shadow suckers hunt with their familiar, a demon which takes the form of a tiny black bird with red eyes and a red beak. The caged familiar birds are merely decoys that elicit a guilt response in potential victims. This guilt trigger is an integral part of the shadow sucker's hunting method, the ultimate aim of which is to suck out the soul from their prey. The area of the brain that the guilt emotion manifests in is the medial prefrontal cortex, which in turn rouses the pineal gland. Throughout history, in countless diverse cultures, the pineal gland, a pinecone-shaped organ that is entirely separate from the brain, has been connected with spirituality and otherworldliness. It is often regarded as the seat of the soul, the sixth chakra, the god organ, and the third eye. A soul is split into two parts. The pineal gland represents the physical part, while the other part, which doesn't have a name or form, exists on some other plane. The two are linked by an ectoplasmic cord, which hovers between time and space dimensions. These juicy transcendental sweets at either end are the soul food that the Shadu is out to get. Unlike the Grey Shrike, the Shadu doesn't have a hooked beak to penetrate skulls, so it must employ more devious tactics. Once the pineal gland is stirred by a guilt trigger, a current of electrostatic discharge trickles into the electroplasmic cord, leaving the connection vulnerable, and it is then that the Shadu can attack. Clutching her purse tightly, the old tourist felt a twinge of shame as she walked away from the caged birds. That remorse was followed by a short stab of pain at the back of her throat, similar to an ice cream headache. The sensation was the result of increased flow to her brain through the anterior cerebral artery. But it wasn't caused by wolfing down a cornetto too quickly. The sensation was caused by a gush of pulpy fluid flowing from her pineal gland as its contents were sucked through her ectoplasmic cord. Meanwhile, on a faraway plane, on a different dimension, a soul screamed as its insides were scooped out like an aborted fetus.